Well, believe it or not, NEWSMEALS has been getting hundreds of requests from people asking for help cooking during the pandemic. Okay, actually, it's only about 12, but frankly, once I get past 10, I fudge the numbers anyway. But what I'm learning is there's generally been one person in the house lately who's been doing all the cooking.
Let's see. What would he like for dinner?
So I'm doing a give someone you love a frickin' break from cooking video. I'm going to show you how to do a quick Italian red sauce that will likely save your marriage. Although, if your marriage is that far gone, I don't think one recipe is going to do it anyway.
I will divorce you so fast it'll make your head spin.
Okay, let's get started. We start with a hot pan and a good dose of extra virgin olive oil.
The other definition of being a virgin.
With our garlic, very Italian. But whatever you do, don't let it burn unless you like that delicious burnt garlic flavor. I don't. We're gonna add our onions. We're gonna do something called sweating our vegetables. That's adding salt to it to start to draw some of that moisture out. Green peppers. See how easy this is? And that's gonna go for 3 or 4 minutes, maybe 5.
That's the general idea.
It's time to add the tomatoes. So here we go. Probably get some more salt in there. Add some pepper. Once that's seasoned a little, we're gonna move on to our tomato paste. About a half a can. And the last thing I'm gonna do with this is to add basil. So I'd say 2 tablespoons, maybe 1 tablespoon of basil, 1 tablespoon of oregano, whatever you think works best. Do you see a pattern here?
We'll see whether I'm crazy or not.
Okay, so believe it or not, this sauce is just about done. Italians say the most important ingredient in tomato sauce is thyme.
Piazza muscoso in the room per la faccia di si pazzi.
Not the spice, but actually looking at your clock and letting it sit and simmer and let all the flavors marry together.
Oh boy! Someone's gonna get married!
Okay, if it's on medium heat right now, to cook this, you want to get it down to a simmer. So, with your red sauce almost done, it's time to move on to the actual pasta. So, we got the water going. Coming up to a nice boil. Now, it's really important though that you add salt. How much salt? A lot. If you've ever been swimming in the ocean and gotten a mouthful from a wave, that's how this should taste. The reason is, this is the only time you can actually flavor your noodles. So let that sit. I'm gonna set a timer for about 10 minutes. So when is pasta done? Well, the Italian term is al dente, which means to the teeth. That means you get a little bit of texture when you bite into the noodle. Just stick with the 10 minutes. You'll be much better off. So we're gonna do some final seasoning. Probably get some more salt in there. Pepper, you can add as much as you want. Keep trying with that, get it to where you want it. And now here's a trick I wanted to show you with parsley. This is the time when you call your wife or spouse or significant other into the kitchen, give them a glass of wine, and let them watch you do this. You take your knife, get your thumb out of the way. Don't ask me how I know.
Think of my thumb, Charlie!
And rest it on the top of the blade and begin to rock. When you get really good at it, you can start to do it really fast. And anybody who watches you in the kitchen thinks you know what you're doing.
You magnificent bastard.
All right, with your final seasoning done, maybe add a little bit of parsley, and you're ready to add your pasta to your sauce. And you are almost done. Time to get the plates out, pour some more wine.
And at times, only a red will do.
Okay, plating. Be generous. Give it a twist. Add some sauce. Your parsley, your Parmesan cheese, and your pepper. And then you're ready to eat.
Gee, that's a swell idea.
And that's it. You are done. Now, I happen to think cooking is fun. I could do it every night, and I usually do. But if you're the one doing it nonstop without a break, having someone step in to help goes a really long way. And who knows, there could be added fringe benefits that I really can't get into right here.
I've heard people say that.
So that's all for now. Keep emailing. My evenings are pretty much free for the time being. Stay safe and eat and drink responsibly. Cheers.